to draw your attention, if you have a program, we're very happy that Mr. and Mrs. Lieber were able to work on the program for us, and I think it's quite nice, and we really appreciate that. Also, I'm going to do these appreciations first, because we have two separate programs and two different groups of children. Also, we have Mrs. Fronick, who is with us to play the piano, and we haven't seen her for a while, since her children have all moved on, but we're very happy that she's here. Mrs. Stevenson is going to be singing with us and providing some music in between, so we're very thankful for that as well. And in our program, we've had a number of parents that we wish to thank: Mrs. Carnes, Mrs. Farrar, Mrs. Glenn, Mrs. Herman, Mrs. Kuhn, Mrs. Lieber, Mrs. Robostad, Mrs. Rowe, and Mrs. Stamper. They have all been very helpful, and I'm sure that you will realize that these things can't happen without some assistance. We have students who are going to be our MCs this morning from our student council. We have Kathy Larippa, who is our vice president, and Jennifer Taylor, who is our treasurer. So I'm going to turn it over to them and let them get started.
Hi, my name is Cammie Larippa, and I'm the vice president of Joe Henderson Student Council.
Hi, my name is Jennifer Taylor, and I'm the treasurer of Joe Henderson Student Council.
We'd like to welcome you to the Joe Henderson Christmas program, so just sit back and relax for a good time.
We'll be your announcers for today. Enjoy the show. Today you'll hear 8 performances in the first part of the Christmas program. Mrs. Stevenson's kindergarten class will be singing Musky Santa as the first performance. classes will be doing Jolly Janitor Jingles, and Mrs. Ross's class will be doing What a World It Would Be If Christmas Lasted All Year Long.
Thank you.
I-S-T-M-A-S.
Thank you.
next presentation by Mrs. Gloripa's second grade class will be Silent Night in Japanese and Let's Have a Party.
Thank you. secretary of the student council, and they are going to be our MCs for this part of the program.
This is a song from France. It's
called Noel. Noel, 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 born is the King of Israel.
In Scandinavia, they celebrate with Saint Lucia, which they have the oldest girl dress up as St. Lucia. She serves coffee and buns to the family while they are still in bed. On December 14th, they have rice pudding and with a single almond. And whoever finds the almond first will have good luck throughout the new year.
Thank you. to eat the trimmings.
We are Santa's elves.
All by herself. She didn't have any children and she was very lonely.
So she decided one day that she would bake herself a little girl. And she baked herself a batch of gingerbread cookies. She put it all together. She rolled out the dough. She cut out the gingerbread girl and she put her in the oven. Now, as the gingerbread girl was cooking, she smelled delicious. And she could smell that gingerbread girl cooking. She opened the oven door to check on the gingerbread girl. And what happened? But the gingerbread girl came alive and ran right out the door. She ran past the house. And as she was running outside in the yard past the house, there was a mouse and an old rabbit who were being chased by a cat and two dogs. And as the gingerbread girl ran past them, they said, but she said, run, run as fast as you can. You can't catch me. I'm the gingerbread girl. Well, as she ran on, she ran away from the house, and outside it was a beautiful sunny day, and there was a butterfly playing in a meadow. The butterfly was playing in the meadow, and the gingerbread girl ran past the butterfly. The butterfly said, stop, gingerbread girl. But the gingerbread girl ran on saying, run, run as fast as you can. You can't catch me. I'm a gingerbread girl. Butterfly just happened to have escaped from Marine World, Africa, USA, butterfly land, you know. And as the gingerbread girl ran into Marine World, there happened to be two dolphins, a frog, and a turtle performing for the crowd. And the gingerbread girl ran on past them. The gingerbread girl ran on past them, and they saw her, and they said, but she said, run, run as fast as you can. You can't catch me. I'm the gingerbread girl. You're right, let's do it again for the benefit of Andrew. Swim, swim as fast as you can. You can't catch me. I'm the gingerbread girl. Deeper into Africa, Marine World, USA, our gingerbread girl happened to meet a lion, a tiger, a bear, oh my, and a monkey who were playing there in Africa, Marine World, USA. Our little gingerbread girl ran past them, and they said, but she said, run, run as fast as you can. You can't catch me. I'm the gingerbread girl. Well, as she left Africa, Marine World, USA, she came out to a pasture where there was a bull and a cow and a horse and a pumpkin that happened to be left over from Halloween out in the pasture grazing. A horse. They were munching on grass, and as the gingerbread girl ran past them, they decided that she looked much more delicious than the grass they were eating, and they too said, but she said,
run, run as fast as you can. You can't catch me, I'm a gingerbread girl.
Now, it's getting awfully close to Christmas time, and so one of the animals that we happen to see at this time of year are reindeer. And there were a couple reindeer out practicing to pull the sleigh on Christmas Eve. And as they were practicing, boy, it sure was hard work. And the gingerbread girl ran past them too. It was hard work and they were hungry, so she said, but the gingerbread girl said,
run, run.
Now, the gingerbread girl next met a pretty fast little animal. Road Runner. Road Runner ran fast, but not fast enough to catch our gingerbread girl. And she said, along about this time, there happened to be two dinosaurs and their friend the fox out playing. They had been able to smell the gingerbread girl coming for a long time, and so they had a plan. They were gonna catch her, and they had a plan. The gingerbread girl was getting a little tired, and she came past them very slowly. And as she came out past them, they said, "Why don't you hop on our back and we'll give you a ride?" So she said, "Sure, that'd be great." She climbed up on their back and they moved a little bit further. And she was getting pretty heavy, even for strong animals like dinosaurs. So they said, "Why don't you climb up a little closer onto our shoulders?" And with that, they threw her off their shoulders. She fell down on the ground, and they opened up their mouths and went chomp. And that was the end of our gingerbread girl and the end of our story.
Thank you.
To end the show, you will see Mr. Wofsy's and Mrs. Rule's second grade classes doing O Tan and Rock.
Three.
husband from work to share this program with us.